We have sold Sable Street property. I wanted to announce what's happening with that, okay? The reason why our elders met together, prayed together, we realized that Sable is not going to be our future, okay? And so now we have money in the bank to search. If you know a building out there that we can make into a church, find it on a main road. You put a lighthouse where everybody can see it so the people can come to it. I'm excited because as a church goes in that type of direction, people get involved, people give, and we're going to need you to serve if we step out on faith and get a place like that. In the meantime, we don't know where that is. So we got to pray. I hope that you pray with us and that God will open a great door for us to do something great in this community.
It is as bad as the experts feared. Hurricane Ian has made landfall in Florida, and the experts say if you had plans to leave and haven't, stay where you are. The storm has intensified to a near Category 5 status, wreaking havoc on everything in its path.
When we look at Scripture, many times God's people are called to suffer. And God puts us through things and it gives glory to God that we continue to have faith, that others see us. Why are we down here singing how great thou art when we've got a mess and so many problems going on? And that is a witness of our faith in God. Joyful is the man or woman that can go through a storm, trials, loss, and get through it trusting God with joy. Why is it going to be so joy? Because you're going to realize you're a child of God. A church is not a building. We are the church right here. We are the church. You know what this storm's also doing? It's bringing us all so much closer together. It really is. What God wants. God wants us to be close together. He's doing that. He's making us stronger. He's making us better. So I say to you, brothers and sisters, don't lose your hope. Don't lose your courage. We have a verbal commitment. It's verbal. That we're going to be out on Toledo Blade in a warehouse. We're going to take over this lease and be there till August. That's the plan, God willing. But I think you're going to like this place. It's not as far as you think.
Well, we've already outgrown our new building. Which is a good problem to have. Picturing the old gone and the new's here. God bless you.
We shout out your praise.
we don't have your email, you haven't heard the good news that the property that we bid on Sumter Blvd, they accepted our bid. So, and I will tell you this, last week, because of our future and our plans to buy and build, we took a special offering. We called it the Chest of Blessing. And I told everyone, we bid $2,075,000 on that property, but we only had $2 million. So I joked in the early service, where's the $75,000 coming? So I pointed at the chest, and I was just joking. Maybe it'll be in here today, right? Because we've never had an offering that high. The Chest of Blessing offering was $167,000. So encouraging. God is behind us. God's people are behind us. And He will provide. So please be praying about that. We're going to need your prayer. We're going to need your help. Construction people are going to come together and help us fix that up. All of us, brothers and sisters, we're going to work. It's going to make our church stronger.
And so for a long time, we've been looking for a church home. And I'll tell you, it's been hard. It's been very hard. In fact, at times, it's been very discouraging. Discouraging. Just to say, you know, God, what is your plan for us? Now to Him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we can ask or think, according to the power at work within us. And this would come to my mind, and I'll be honest with you, there were senses of doubt and senses of belief. Just, God, I believe you can do this. I believe you can do so much better than I can think of. But the question is, where is it? Where is it? And when is it coming? How long are we going to be looking for this? And I will tell you now that we have this location, that we have this building. And not just the building, but to see what it looks like after we've been able to renovate it. God has given us more abundantly than we could have ever asked for. And I really hope that first Sunday when you guys walk into this building, I really hope you don't see it and marvel at the physicalness of the building, how beautiful it is, and how miraculous you think it is. I really hope you see it and it leads you to praise God for everything that He has done for Freedom Bible Church. Everything that He has done for us. Because none of it was possible unless He provided it, right? And so I hope you praise Him when you see it. I hope you see it and you're so excited for what God is not just doing now, but what He plans to do with us in this building in the future, right? And it's going to be so incredible.
Thank you. Is